that was my quick and struggling lookbook of the early 2000s, which was my childhood. I still have a lot of things from the early 2000s, actually. I'm just halfway across the planet, so I don't have a good portion of my things. I still have my razor, not like shaving razor, but like if you grew up during that time, you know which razor I'm talking about. It was hot pink. I had the hot pink one because I was a cool kid. A lot of the stuff I showed you today was things that I bought in, well, over here in Seoul, South Korea. 90s, like, Clueless, and then early 2000s fashion is very big here, so I'm taking advantage while also paying attention to my wallet because I'm still a broke person. And then the thing that I need to remind myself on a daily basis that I am still a broke person. A lot of the skirts are very accurate to how short skirts were worn in the early 2000s, not so much anymore in America. I'm sure I'm gonna get looks when I come back with those, but other than the white one. Other than the pleated skirts, the tight ones are the ones that I know people are going to be like, why are you wearing something so short? Over here, short skirts aren't a big deal. In the early 2000s, that was, I call them the early 2000s length of short skirts. My berets I bought off of eBay for $1. A lot of my accessories come from eBay for $1 and under. I would do more in-depth 2000s, late 90s inspired, my childhood inspired accessories when I come back to America, God willing, okay. I plan on buying butterfly clips because I haven't, not rebuying because my mom bought me my butterfly clips when I was a little kid. Because I was a little kid, I didn't have a job. But, you can get a pack of like 100 of them for $9 off of Amazon. I won't need 100. I mean, maybe I will, those things break easily. Anyway, I'll do far more like early 2000s, late 90s-esque type things. There are a lot of aspects of the early 2000s that I will not touch because that was just a crime to fashion. But there's other things that I still like and enjoy. And so if you would like to see more of that and you'd like to see better films, lookbooks, because this Korean dorm is the size of a closet that I share with one other person. And in America, this literally just would be illegal because there's actually supposed to be a certain amount of space between people, but because Korea developed so quickly, I can explain that another time. So there really isn't any space to actually probably film a lookbook. So this will probably be the only one. I might do an outfit of the day at Lotte World, because I'm supposed to be going to Lotte World for my 21st birthday, but enough rambling for 3 minutes and now 27, 28, 29 seconds. If you would like to see more, please subscribe, I guess, if you want. I'm not going to force you, I'm still going to make videos anyway, it's good practice. But if you want to, it'd be appreciated. Okay, I'm gonna go.